Hello friends, my name is Kishan and welcome you in this video tutorial. In this video tutorial, we are going to talk about the meta space memory, which is the one of the enhancement in Java 8. And this meta space is basically that is the substitution of paramgen memory. So you can see in the slide what I have written from paramgen to meta space. Paramgen memory space has been removed from the Java 8. Now, what is meta space? A new memory space in Java 8. Java classes have an internal representation within Java Hotspot virtual machine and are referred to as a class metadata. In previous releases of Java Spot, basically before JDK 1.8 virtual machine, the class metadata was allocated in the so-called permanent generation or permgen. In JDK 1.8, the permanent generation was removed and the class metadata is allocated in native memory. The amount of native memory that can be used for class metadata is by default unlimited or unbounded. As the permanent generation or permgen space has completely been removed and is kind of replaced by a new space called meta space in Java 8. The consequences of paramgen removal is that obviously the param size and max param size JVM arguments are ignored and you will never get a out of memory paramgen error. In JDK 1.8, the param size and max param size JVM arguments are ignored and a warning is issued if present at startup. So if in VM argument, if you try to set size for the paramgen, then once you run the program, then you'll get this warning on the console, Eclipse console or whatever IDE you are using, you'll get this warning on that console, like Java Hotspot, my machine is 64 bits, so saying that 64-bit server VM warning, ignoring option max size, whatever max size you are trying to set, support was removed in Java 8. So these things we'll see through a demo project, end of the demo. Now, before proceeding, digging out about the meta space, let's try to answer few questions, like what is heap and native memory? So heap memory is the memory within the JVM process that is managed by the JVM to represent Java objects. Now what about native memory? Native memory is also called off heap memory. So native memory is memory allocated within the process's address space that is not within the heap, that is the apart from the heap. Something I have written important in the note. For a Java process, the user space can be logically divided into heap memory and native memory. Size of heap memory is dictated by -XMS and -XMX. So if you want to set the minimum size of your heap, then you use the VM argument like -XMX. This is the initial size of heap. And max size of heap is dictated by the VM argument -XMX, right? And after that you specify the size. There are no options with which we can manage the native memory, as this is memory this is done by the JVM for you, right? So there is no VM argument to set the native memory. This is done by the JVM for you. It is always a best practice to constantly check the native memory consumption and detect leaks before your application dies with an out of memory exception. Heap memory is just the portion of user space managed by JVM. Now, when I ask you, is metadata also native memory? Then answer would be yes. Metadata, meta space is a part of native memory or process memory and is limited by the host operating system. Now, what is the use of Java native memory? Then I found the best explanation Native memory is an area which is usually used by the JVM for its internal operations and to execute the Java Native Interface, that is also called JNI codes. The JVM uses native memory for code optimization and for loading the classes and libraries along with the intermediate code generation. The size of the native memory depends on the architecture of the operating system and the amount of memory which is already committed to the Java heap. Native memory is a process area where the JNI codes gets loaded or the JVM library gets loaded. There is no JVM option available to size the native area, but we can calculate it approximately using the following formula. Like if you add a space of max heap size and plus max param size, and that addition, if you subtract from the process size, then you'll get the approximate size of native memory. But this will work before the JDK 1.8, because from JDK 1.8 onwards, there is nothing like a max param size. Now, meta space memory in Java 8. So prior to Java 8, we had a JVM hotspot memory structure like this. First we have a Eden space, then survivor 1, survivor 2, then then we had a old generation for older object, and we had a param gen or permanent generation for VM metadata. Now permanent generation for VM metadata is completely removed from the Java 8, and they have added meta space VM metadata in the native memory. So meta space memory has been added. So Java applications are allowed to use only a limited amount of memory. The exact amount of memory your application can use is specified during the application startup itself. To make things more clear, Java memory is separated into different regions, as you can see in this picture. Now meta space memory in Java 8, we'll see some more details. The size of all those regions, including the meta space area, can be specified during the JVM launch itself. If you do not determine the sizes yourself, platform specific defaults will be used or taken. The out of memory, so the java.lang.out of memory meta space message indicates that the meta space area in memory is exhausted. A new memory area called meta space was introduced and param gen was removed. This change made due to variety of regions, including but not limited to this region only. So some of the important reason I have written in this slide, and that may be the reason to replace param gen into meta space. The required size of param gen was hard to predict. It resulted in either under provisioning triggering java.lang.out of memory param gen size errors, or over provisioning resulting in wasted resources, right? Now second reason was to remove param gen GC performance, garbage collector performance. Improvements enabling concurrent class data deallocation without GC pauses and specific iterators on the metadata. Now third reason, support for further optimizations such as G1 concurrent class unloading. So G1 is one of the garbage collector who is responsible to unload the classes from the memory. Now if you were familiar with param gen, then all you need to know as background is that whenever was in param gen before Java 8, name and fields of the class, methods of the class with the bytecode of the method, constant pool, here I'm talking about the string constant pool, JIT optimization is now located in the meta space. So these things have been removed from the param gen, and now these functionality is shifted to the meta space memory. Meta space size requirements depend both upon the number of class loaded as well as the size of such class declarations. So it is easy to see the main cause for the java.lang.out-of-memory error meta space is either too many classes or too big classes being loaded to the meta space. Now, how to simulate out of memory meta space error, that we'll see in end of the demo. Now here, what is the solution for out of memory meta space? If application exhausts the meta space area in the memory, you should indicate the size of you should increase the size of meta space by specifying this VM argument max meta space size, and whatever size you want to set, you can set. The above configuration example tells the JVM that meta space is allowed to grow up to 512 MB before it can start complaining in the form of out of memory, right? Another solution you have is even simpler at first solution. You can remove the limit on meta space size together by deleting this parameter, but you will have to pay attention to the fact that by doing so, you can introduce heavy swapping and or to reach native allocation failure instead, right? In note part, I have written something important. The above recommendation quick fixes, you end up masking the symptoms by hiding the out of memory meta space and not tackling the underlying problem. If your application leaks memory or just loads something unreasonable into meta space, the above solution will does not improve anything. It will just postpone the problem, right? So this was just high level insight on the meta space. Now let's try to simulate it. So as I said, from Java 8 onwards, there is nothing like a PromGen memory. So I have created a project over here, and here I have created two classes. First, I have created PromGen warning simulator. So here I'll show you the warning if you try to save PromGen site. So here go to the VM argument. Here I have selected PromGen warning. In VM argument, you can set -xx max param size, and here I'm trying to size the specify 512 m, and apply and run. So here you are getting this warning saying that ignoring options max param size 512 mb, support was removed in Java 8. So from Java 8 onwards, there is nothing like a PromGen, so that's why you are getting this error. Now let's go to simulate how to simulate out of memory for the meta space. So here I have added an external jar is called javasyst. So I'm going to show this demo using this jar. So I will use class pool over here, and what I'll do, class pool has a factory method, so that I'm going to use. Okay, no problem. So class pool has a method is called get default, and I'm going to use get default method over here, and let's use a iterator, and I will iterate this loop around 1 million times, and here I'm going to use this reference to load class. Method is called make class. And here I'm going to pass this class, qualified name of this class, and I would say make solid.